Welcome to SINUMERIK Live, Application Technology Simply Explained, our video series aimed at explaining topics relating to SINUMERIK in an easy and practical manner. Today's subject is turn milling on the CY axis and the principle and application using SINUMERIK Operate on the milling machine. Our agenda for today: first, we'll talk about the fundamentals of turning and turn milling and the possible applications. This will be followed by an example of the implementation of turn milling with SINUMERIK Operate in both theory and practice. And finally, the production of a workpiece on our machine tool. The development of CNC turning machines has been marked by the increasing complexity of such machining centers and, of course, of the parts that they produce. Production times have become shorter, and much more complicated parts can now be produced even within this shorter time. It all began with cycle-controlled machines using the X and Z axis and continued via machines with CY axes, turning milling machines, our topic for today, right through to machines with a B axis, known as multiple spindle machines, or beyond these, to Swiss-type automatic lathes. How do we define turning? A rotating workpiece is machined into shape as stock is removed by a fixed tool. This is done on the X and the Z axis. If flat areas, contours, pockets are to be machined into a component with rotational symmetry, such as this one, additional axes are required. In our case, these are the C axis and the Y axis. The C axis is in the main spindle. In other words, the main spindle is derived from a rotational movement. It becomes a positioned and controlled axis, which can either be held at specifically defined positions or, as a result, can move under control in any plus or minus direction. These pockets or surfaces, for example, can then be implemented, and additionally in our case, we then still have a Y axis. This is a 100% milling spindle. This provides the opportunity to implement precisely the same applications, cycles, and use cases as in a proper milling machine. The key difference between the C and the Y axis is that, in contrast to the C axis, the Y axis allows machining outside the center point of the workpiece. What can I do with the C or the Y axis? The C and Y axis permit drilling and milling operations, not only on the cylinder surface, but also on the front face of the workpiece. Let's begin with the C axis. For the C axis, that is an interpolation of the main spindle, in other words, a compensatory motion. I can, for example, cut a pocket here on the cylinder surface. Here the tool cannot leave the center of the workpiece. It's therefore essential that there is a compensatory movement, we refer to this as interpolation movement, of the C axis in order to ultimately achieve this dimension of the pocket. I can, of course, also cut a flat surface from the front face, again by interpolation of the C axis, or even drill holes into the front face. These holes drilled in the front face can also be implemented using the Y axis. In contrast to the C axis, I don't need interpolation here. That's to say, compensatory movement, since the Y axis can travel beyond the center point of the workpiece axis. This allows pockets with flat bases to be created, as well as grooves. And of course, both can be done with cutter radius compensation.
Kommen wir
we now move from the fundamentals of turn milling to the application of turn milling with SINUMERIK Operate. A programmed traversing movement must be transformed into the actual traversing movement of the CNC machine according to the kinematic preconditions. We make a distinction here between two functionalities. On the one hand, TRACYL, that's the cylinder surface transformation, and on the other hand, TRANSMIT. TRANSMIT stands for transform milling into turning. To transform milling into turning without the Y-axis, the CNC controller requires a kinematic transformation for mapping the coordinate systems. In summary, you could say that TRANSMIT permits the full range of drilling and milling for the front face of rotating workpieces. In exactly the same way as with the front face machining, all turning machines with driven tools are suitable for TRACYL, in other words, cylinder surface machining. If machine tool radius compensation is necessary for this cylinder surface transformation, a Y-axis is essential. Here once again in comparison. On the left, we see machining with TRACYL without machine tool radius compensation. And on the right, we see TRACYL with machine tool radius compensation. Machining without machine tool radius compensation is performed using the C-axis. This inevitably creates inclined walls and a domed base. This, as already mentioned, results from the interpolation of the C-axis. During TRACYL machining with machine tool radius compensation, our Y-axis is used, giving us straight walls and a flat base, and of course also enabling machining with machine tool radius compensation. In our practical section, we are demonstrating conventional turning techniques such as face turning and longitudinal turning, in other words, the technologies for manufacturing rotationally symmetrical parts. And, of course, also the milling applications, in this case a turn milling machine, machining on the cylinder surface with the C-axis, on the cylinder surface with the Y-axis, and of course also front face machining operations, both with the C and the Y-axis. We begin with the everyday face turning operation. This operation, according to the technical jargon, planes the front face of the workpiece, and this is followed by overturning, longitudinal turning to create the diameter, that is to say, the external diameter. The same mask is used here again, only this time in relation to the turning technology in longitudinal turning. In this case, the next steps are the milling of the square with a milling tool, to be precise, in the area of the Y-axis, followed by the program with the subsequent steps, machining with the C-axis to mill a polygon. And in this way, the Y-axis and C-axis machining operations alternate. These technologies can easily be combined. This is done by selecting the C-axis on the front face or Y-axis on the front face. With pocket machining too, you can very easily select cylinder surface machining with the Y-axis or front face machining with the C-axis. Either way, the process is very reliable. Animated elements assist you in your selection. Here you see cylinder surface machining with the C-axis. This is done by interpolating the C-axis and simultaneously rotating the milling tool. And here is a very nice view of the machining taking place. It's similar for the Y-axis. In this way, as already indicated, you obtain a flat base and vertical walls. Now we start the program for executing our workpiece. Thank you. Anyone who decides to extend their manufacturing process with the technology of turn milling first has to invest in machinery and personnel. This saves a considerable amount of time thanks to reduced tooling times. Machine idle times are cut, throughput times are speeded up, delivery periods are shorter, and of course, the company optimizes the range machinery at its disposal. Thanks for watching. See you next time.